Good morning, dear students. Today I'll tell you about what is the difference between file and a folder. Okay, so student, first of all, try to understand that how can we create a folder. So we have to right click on the blank area of a desktop. A context menu will appear. We have to click on new and then folder. So by clicking onto the new option, and we can go to the folder. A folder will appear on your desktop area, and there we can give a name to a folder. So here I am giving a name. And what could be the name? I am giving a name computer. Okay, computers is the name for a folder. Now I'll double click on this folder and I'll go inside. Here what I'll do, I'll show you that how can you create a file there. Okay, so I clicked on a new item option. Through the new items, there are multiple files are there: Word file, presentation files, Excel file, text documents. Okay, let me click into any one of them, and then I'll show you that how can we create a document file here. So this is now a document file. I'll right click it and I'll rename it. So what name I am giving? Name I am giving my first document. Okay, now see, I'm typing a name which is my first document. Okay, now students, what will happen? See, this is a file which I have created here, but here I can also create a subfolder. A folder inside a folder, as I have told you, is known as a subfolder. So now folder is created within a folder. Now I'll give a name to this folder. Let's say let's give class 5. So the name of the folder is now class 5. Okay, now see what will happen, students. Now this I have created a folder and a file within a folder. So what is a folder? Folder is a collection of files. Okay, now see, I am showing you the extra large icons, small icons, details, content, and everything, and this is available in the view tab. So you have to click on the folder, go to the view tab, and you can change the icons according to you. But you it is advisable that we should save our documents in the details view, so that we can see the last modification date, type, and the size of a document. Okay, so detail view is always advisable. Okay, instead of large or small or extra large icons, go to the details view and save your document in the detail view. Okay students, so that you can see the modification date, type, and the size of your document, students. Okay, so here I told you what about how to create a folder and a file within a folder, a folder within a folder, which is known as a subfolder. Now students, I'll tell you very important thing. Now see students, what I am doing, I'll tell you how can you rename a folder. Just right click on a folder, go to the rename option, and start renaming a folder, and then press enter. Your folder will be renamed. Okay, likewise you can also rename your file. Right click and go to the rename option, your file will be renamed. Okay students, which is very simple. Now I have shown you that I have deleted this folder, and my folder is my folder went to the recycle bin. Okay, now I'll go to the recycle bin. See, my computer folder, it is available here. What I'll do, I'll show you how can you restore it back. So you have to select your folder, then what you have to do is, after selecting your folder, either you can empty your recycle bin or you can restore your item. So restoring item is very important. Sometimes we delete a files, but we urgently need that file, so we can go to recycle bin and we can restore the selected item. So if I click on restoring a selected item, then it will be restored back. Okay, and it will be in the same location from where I have deleted the folder. See now students, what I can do is, I can again delete it. See, and I'm again deleting and going back to recycle bin. And see, it is already here. Then I can click on this and I can select all the items. And if I click on empty recycle bin, my recycle bin is now empty. Okay, it is asking for yes or no. I said yes. Now my recycle bin is empty. So we can empty our recycle bin and we can also restore data from there. So now students, see, this is the folder on which I have clicked. There are certain files and folders available here. Now students, what will happen if there are certain files and folders? I have shown you how can you select all. Now pressing Ctrl plus A will select all the files and folders. Ctrl plus A key combination. If you want to select some limited portion, just drag the mouse over the files and folders. They will get selected, students. Suppose if you want to select a single file, just click onto that file. That file will be selected, like the first one which I have shown you. I have clicked on that file and that file is selected. Now students, if I want to select multiple files, then I have to press the Ctrl key and then I'll be clicking on the multiple files. Those files will get selected. So this is a method of selecting the files. Ctrl plus A for all. Some selected portion, just drag the mouse. Single file, just click onto that. And multiple files, Ctrl plus click the cursor. Okay, those files will be selected, students. So student, this was all about files and folders. I have told you that what is the difference between file and a folder. File is a collection of data and information, where folder is a collection of files, students. Got it? एंड स्टूडेंट्स इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास आई